The next phase is the inference phase. Now your models are in production and you will use it in the real situation, in the real world. You deploy your model and then you use your model to predict an output, to predict a result using your input data as the input. It's important to say that the input data should be in the same distribution that the training data, because you train a model using a kind of data, and you, now that your model is in production, you have to use the same kind of data, the data with the same distribution. Very simple example, if you are training your model with structured data, numbers for example, you cannot use text in now in the inference data. You have to use the same kind of data. This is very important, because if you are not do that, your model will not produce a result. But assuming that you are using new data, data that you have never seen as input data, but this, with the same distribution, you will get a result, an output result. And that result you will pass to the task. You probably remember when I explained that you use machine learning during tasks, during parts, to recognition, to predict, to generate, and it's part of bigger task and bigger process. And then your task probably will continue with a decision, with an action, with an output, and the results of the output probably will generate and feedback. You collect that feedback. And this, again, this is a phase that you will iterate and run this model 100,000 millions of times, and you will collect the feedbacks from the results of your tasks and the input data, and this will generate a new data, okay? And this is the inference phase. Which roles are responsible to help us to put that in production? The machine learning engineers, for sure, and also the software engineers, because and software developers, because they are the ones that understand infrastructure. The software developers, for example, are the ones that will plug your model in the rest of your task, in the programming, or will prepare, or someone will prepare to show that information to a person, for example, to take a decision, yes, and return a feedback. Then we conclude the inference phase. The fifth and the last phase is the evolution phase. And why is evolution? Now we decided at the beginning the situation, we collect the data, we build a model, and then we put the model in production, and we use that model in production. But in some point of time, we need to evaluate exactly the results of the tasks that use AI. They are producing, in fact, a value. We define a measure, and now is the time to really see if the results of the task, the outcomes of the task, are really producing the value that we have defined previously. Yes, this is the time to compare your expectation with the real results in the world and see if the value is in fact the one that you were expecting to receive. Probably you will see that, okay, it's good but not great. And because, for example, 80% inaccuracy, it's not good enough. We should improve that, we can improve that. And then we will use, for example, all the input data that we are collecting, because this model is in production, with the feedbacks, and prepare a new data, a new raw data, yes, and maybe to analyze again this data and use this data to retrain your model, to train again, but now you will train with data from the real world, from real situations. You have feedback if the model is doing okay or not, and then you will retrain the model, iterate again in the modeling phase, and probably your accuracy will continue to improve, maybe to 90, maybe to 95, and then you will move it again to production. And that's the reason why this is a cycle, because this is a never-ending process. Yes, you start at the beginning, but then you have to keep moving this cycle, because maybe your value is in one situation, then you want to improve, but the data in the real world, they change. Maybe the situation with new data is changing a little, and you are losing some value, and then you have to retrain your model. This retraining could be manual, but it also could be automatic, yes? Well, this is an AI cycle. This is a process how you manage your AI projects, and with five different phases: situation phase, data phase, modeling phase, inference phase, and then the evolution phase, okay? With this, we've concluded the enablers.